Let's make one more tutorial in Autodesk Fusion. In this video, you'll learn how to create this crankshaft, and you'll learn how to use the extrude, cylinder, hole, fillet, and extruded cut in Autodesk Fusion. So open the Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this crankshaft, we will select the right plane and make this sketch here, okay? This sketch is from this part here. So let's create this. Here will be our midpoint. The first thing that we'll make here, create this construction line with 40 millimeters and create this arc here with 20 millimeters of radius. So open the Fusion, go to create a sketch, select the right plane, select line, a construction line, make a construction line here with 40 millimeters. And go to create, select arc, center point arc, remove the construction line type. The radius here is 20 millimeters. Make an arc here. We made this. Now let's create this arc here. The center of this arc is the midpoint, and the radius 50 millimeters, and the distance between these two points here is 8 millimeters. So go to create, select the arc, center point arc, click at the midpoint here. The radius here is 50 millimeters. Make an arc here. Go to construct, select horizontal vertical, select these two points here. And go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 8 millimeters. We made this. Now let's create this sketch here. We'll put the dimensions later. So select line, make a line here, make an arc here, and make another line here. The radius of this arc here is 32.5 millimeters, and the distance between the center of this arc and the midpoint is 20 millimeters. So go to sketch dimension, the radius here, 32.5, and the distance between this point and this point here is 20 millimeters. We made this. Now go to create, select mirror, select this line, this arc, and this line here. Select the mirror line. The mirror line is this construction line, and press OK. We made this. Now finish the sketch, go to extrude. We need to extrude this 10 millimeters. So the distance here, 10 millimeters. Operation new body, press OK. We have a cylinder here, so let's create this. This cylinder here has 30 millimeters of diameter and 40 millimeters of length. So here go to create, select cylinder, select this face here, click at the midpoint. The diameter here is 30 millimeters. And the length here is 40 millimeters. Operation join, press OK. Now let's create another cylinder here. This cylinder has 20 millimeters of diameter and the length here is 40 millimeters. Go to create, select cylinder, select this face here, click at the midpoint, the diameter 20 millimeters, and the extrusion here 40 millimeters. Operation join, press OK. We made this. Now let's create this hole here. This hole has 8 millimeters of diameter, and the deep here is 10 millimeters. So go to create, select hole, select this face, select the edge reference in this edge here, the deep 10 millimeters, and the diameter 8 millimeters, press OK. Let me show for you. We made this cut here in this hole. Now we need to create this cut here, this one here. Here we have the distance here, 2 millimeters. So we have 2 millimeters here. Let me show for you, 2 millimeters here. And the length here, the distance here is 4 millimeters. And we needed to make a cut here, 30 millimeters plus 2 millimeters of radius. So 15 millimeters, okay? So open the Fusion. Go to create a sketch, select this face here. Go to create, select the project, include the project, select this edge here. Press OK. Hide this body. Go to create, select the 2-point rectangle, center rectangle. Make a rectangle here, 4 millimeters by 2 millimeters. Go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here. And go to constraint again, select the tangent, select this line here and this circle. And press OK. Show the body here. Go to extrude, select this profile. We needed to make a cut here with minus 15 millimeters. Operation cut, press OK. We made this cut here. Now we needed to add a fillet here with 2 millimeters of radius. So go to modify, select the fillet. Select this edge here. And select this edge here. The fillet here is 2 millimeters. And press OK. We made this. OK. Now let's create this cylinder here with 30 millimeters of diameter and the length 20 millimeters. So go to create, select cylinder, select this face here, find the center of this arc here. When you see this symbol, this circle, that means it is in the same center of this arc. The diameter here is 30 millimeters. And the extrusion here is 20 millimeters. Operation join, press OK. Now we need to create this part here. It is similar to this one, but here we have a cylinder here. So here in the sketch, we'll have a circle here. We'll have a line here, tangent. And a circle here. This circle here has 40 millimeters of diameter. So let me show you. Go to create a sketch. Select this face. Go to create. Select the project, include project. Select this face here. Press OK. Now select the circle. Click at the midpoint. Make a circle here with 40 millimeters. Now select a line, click at this point, make a line here, tangent with the circle, the same here. And finish the sketch. We have this profile here. So go to extrude. We needed to extrude this 10 millimeters. So select this circle, this profile here, and this circle here. We needed to extrude this 10 millimeters. Operation join, press OK. We made this. Now we needed to make this cylinder here. 40 millimeters of diameter and 30 millimeters of length. So go to create, select cylinder, select this face, select the midpoint here. 40 millimeters of diameter and the length here is 30 millimeters. Press OK. We made this. Now let's make this cut here. Let me erase all this red lines here. We needed to make this cut. Okay, this cut here, we'll go to create a sketch, select the right plane, the front plane, sorry. Go to create, select project, include project, the selection filter, select bodies, select this body here, press OK. I will hide this body a little bit. We have this. Now select the line, construction line, select the center of this line here, make a line here. Remove the construction line type and click at this line and this line here. Okay. We made this line. The angle between this line here and the construction line is a half of 34 degrees. So it is 17 degrees. Okay. So go to sketch dimension. The angle here, 17 degrees. And the distance between this point here and this line here is 22 millimeters. Select this point, this line here, 22 millimeters. Okay, let me make this point coincident with this line here. Now go to create, select mirror, select this line. The mirror line is this construction line, press OK. We have this two profile here that we'll use to make a cut. So finish the sketch, go to extrude, select this two profile here, show the bodies here. The direction, select symmetric, the extended type, select all. We'll make this cut in the both sides and press OK. We made this. Now we need to add the fillet. So here in this edge and in this edge, we have a fillet with 2 millimeters of radius. So go to modify, select the fillet, select this head and select this head. The fillet here is 2 millimeters. Now add selection set. The fillet here in this head, this one, it all 1 millimeters, okay? Here we don't have fillet. So let's create this. And we have a fillet here with 2 millimeters of radius. Select this face here. This face. Select this face here. Select this face here. This face and this face. The fillet here is 1 millimeters. Add selection set, select this head and this one. The fillet here is 1 millimeters. And that's it, press OK. And here we finish your exercise. So thanks for watching, subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next videos. Bye bye.